We're here today with Curtis Youngblood, the legendary Curtis Youngblood, the one that's won most awards as my hero. He's the one who's created the, I guess he's considered him the godfather of 3D flying.
The old guy 3D flying, yeah.
Okay. Okay. And in the meantime, I'm here with him, and I would like to take the time to have a chat with him regarding a few things that pertains to his product, as well as some of the short histories about himself. Now, I would like to move the floor to Curtis. You can say hello to everybody in the Philippines.
Oh, hello, Philippines.
Okay.
Mabuhay.
Yeah, let's see. So, maybe we can start things off by simply having a short introduction about yourself so that that way, you know, we get a feel for it. Is it, how did you get started in the hobby and what progressed into it and where we are now, so to speak?
Yeah, well, I started in the hobby with my father. He's been flying in the hobby since the 1950s. Airplanes and helicopters in the 70s, so I grew up in pictures of me as a little kid around helicopters with him. So I grew up doing helicopters and started helicopters in the early 80s and did contests with my dad and went to college, you know, mechanical engineer, and ended up making models for a living and competing and having fun, basically.
Wow, okay. Seems like you're taking the word fun to a completely new level.
Okay.
Now, we have just finished and witnessed the first 3DX in China.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Yeah, good event.
Yeah, and based on that reason, anyways, since we've seen something that's been going on in China, I guess we can say that it's safe to say that it's pretty impressive what you saw.
Yeah, it was a good event, good pilots, good location. The organizers, especially for the first event, did a very good job.
Okay.
Very good job.
So in your opinion, when it comes to the pilots in itself, what is their caliber in terms of the first time that it's being held there?
It was very good, very good. I mean, I've talked to several people about it. The internet seems to have a big effect on people's ability to see what's happening globally.
Mm-hmm.
They can go on there and see what the guys at the Masters did and someone else did, so they know where the marker is, what they're trying to hit.
Mm-hmm.
And so the good guys here are just as good as the good guys at the Masters, honestly. I mean, there's some really good pilots.
Mm-hmm. Okay. So that's a good point. Okay. Now, from there, anyways, what potentials can you see in what's going to happen in China within the next 3 to 5 years from what you saw in terms of the talent that's there?
Well, what we've seen every place, in fact, where the Masters first started, what we saw when you first go there, there's two or three guys that are just top level. I mean, no one is even close. There's like these guys and then a step, and everybody else is below.
Uh-huh.
And within a year or two, you all of a sudden have a big batch of people that are all very, very good.
Wow.
And it tends to help that country or that region grow in the level of pilots. So, yeah, I would expect this whole area to get considerably better. I mean, they're already very good, but on par with the rest of the world, and as far as depth of pilots.
Okay.